Hi friends, I am Chandrasekhar here again. Now we are into the third lecture in the series of lecture on yogas, as we will see. We started with exactly what is the concept of yoga. Then we went on to yogas where sun is essential. Now we shall go to the next planet in the order of importance. Like as you know, sun is the Atma and that is soul of a person. His self-confidence, his strength of character also, if you want to call it that, but primarily self-confidence. And now we come to moon. Moon is called the mind of the Jataka. And it is said, Indu sarvatra bija bho. Indu means moon, sarvatra means everywhere, bija means seed of everything. Because out of the mind arise the action. And those actions lead to certain results. And these results we try to analyze from the charts. That is why many a times, if those who have sometime corresponded with me or heard my lectures, I always say that most of the remedies arise out of your karma. And this karma is ruled by your mind. So, sometimes controlling the mind, sometimes using it properly, is the way to override many of the problems that one is likely to face in this life. There is nobody who has no problems. We may not know their problems. It's a different part altogether. So we shall now see the yogas where moon is essential in the yoga. There are other yogas where moon is also considered. One of them I might talk about in this lecture. But then it is dependent also on another planet. Both of them together can only do something. Now here what is happening is, it is said Sahasra Rashmi Chandra. Sahasra Rashmi Chandra. See, Sahasra Rashmi is the name of sun. So in Sanskrit, because he has thousand of rays. And Chandra is moon. Kantakadi Gate Krama. Now this Kantaka is, you know, squares are called Kantaka. If you are, I don't remember whether I have talked about that in the lectures on Bhavas, but they are also called Kantakas. Dhanadhi, Nipunadini, Nyuna, Madhyama Uttamadini. I'll give the shloka. I'm only giving the gist, the words might be here and there, but what it means is, if sun is in squares from moon, the person will have less number of, less quantum of wealth, intellect and expertise. What it means, it also implies that if it is the Panavara, the next to Kendra, the Bhava that is next to Kendra is called the Panavara Bhava. Remember this. Then it is medium. What is medium? Wealth. He is being expert in something and his intellect. And it is extreme, highest, uttama, best, when sun is in the apoklimasthana from moon. So remember, it is easy to remember. Square, you know. Next to square is Panavara Bhava and next to that is the apoklima bhava. So go on like this and you will understand where is the apoklima. Many a times we think that X bhava is like fifth is the Trikona bhava, but it is also Panavara bhava. Sixth is the apoklima bhava. So remember that. Don't think that it is only square and trines and all those. No, this is something different. So this is what is said about the position of sun from moon with respect to moon. Now here everything will be from respect to moon, with respect to moon. That is why I am calling them Chandra Yogas. Yogas where moon is important. Moon is the point of reference. Then another very interesting shloka, which is many a time missed even by me, many a times when I analyze chart, is Swansheva Swadhi Mitranshi. It means either when moon is in his own Amsha, Swamsha, not the Swamsha of Jaimini. Remember this. This is Swamsha means in his own Osho means in Cancer Nama Osho. Or his bosom friend's Nama Osho. Now, bosom friend, I think we have talked about Panchadha Maitri, the Naisargik Maitri, the five types of friendships. Of course, five types of enmities also. And so, one is a natural friendship and another is a temporary friendship, which is based on from the position of the planet 2, 3, 4 and, you know, naturally there are 12, 11 and 10. Are mitras and others are enemies and so on. So it is very easy to understand. Refer to that. When a planet is both a temporary and a natural friend of moon, and if moon happens to be placed in his Navamsha, and if the birth is of daytime, I told you, yoga doesn't happen on a single parameter. It has to have multiple parameters. Now we see that the placement of the Navamsha is important, that the birth has to be in the daytime is important. Guruna drushyate yatra tatra jato dhana sukhanvita. And if he is aspected by Jupiter, then that person has wealth and happiness. This is a very rarely used yoga given by the sage Parashara, but it is important. Remember that. And then what is next? We know that if it is a daytime birth and moon happens to be in Cancer Namasha or Namasha of his bosom friend, as I call it, Adhimitra. Friend is either temporary or natural. When a planet is both natural and a temporary friend because of its placement from moon, and the birth is in daytime and moon is aspected by Jupiter, then the person has got wealth and happiness. What happens if he is born in night time? So the next line of the shloka is Swamshe va Swadhimitramshe Sitasya Shani Bhram Nishi. If moon is placed in similar Navamsha but the birth is of night time, then if he is aspected by Venus, again the Jataka, the one who is born, about whose chart we are talking, is well endowed with wealth and happiness. Then he goes on to say, etas viparitas se. If it is the other way around, and if for a night birth in such a case Jupiter is aspecting, or in a day birth if Venus aspects moon, then the person can be may not have much wealth, may even be pauper and a bit unhappy. Now this is hyperbole, but what it means is the yoga caused when a particular placement of moon with aspect of Jupiter, birth is daytime, then good results. If it is night, then he better be aspected by Venus. But if it is vice versa, then the results are not good. So this is again a Chandra Yoga, remember that. This is rarely understood as a Chandra Yoga. The next one which I am talking about will be understood as a Chandra Yoga. It is called the Adi Yoga. There are two types of Adi Yoga. Actually, there are more than two. One is Lagnadhi Yoga, when Lagna is the reference point. This one is called the Chandradhi Yoga, Adhi Yoga of Chandra. So, Chandra Radhradhi Kamasthai is what is said. Syad Adhi Yoga Ka. When Adhi Yoga happens, when from moon in the 6th, 7th and 8th Bhava, Saumya Syadhi Yoga Ka, that is what Parashara says. If benefits are placed in the 6th, 7th and 8th Bhava from moon, then Adhi Yoga is caused. When a person becomes either a king or a minister or even a senapati, commander-in-chief of the army, when does it happen? If the Saumya Grahas, the benefics occupy the 8th house, he becomes a king. If he occupies the seventh house, he becomes a mantri, that is minister. And if a benefic occupies the sixth house, then he becomes the commander-in-chief, krama, that is what he said. And balakramat is said. I am giving the shlokas down below so that there is no confusion. They have to be in strength. The saumya, the benefics have to have strength. Personally, I think it also means moon also must have strength. What strength is generally the pakshabala has to be there. This is my understanding. I may be wrong. It might only refer to the saumya, the benefics who occupy the 6, 7 or 8 houses should have strength is what is said. But I suppose even moon must have some strength. Then another yoga, which is also rarely thought about as being a yoga option. They say Chandra Vruddhingato Sarve Shubhe Jato Mahadhani. Now what is this Vruddhingato? Vruddhi is Upachaya, in which I think 10th bhava is not considered. You know the 3, 6, 10 and 11 are called the bhavas of Vruddhi or Upachaya bhavas, the bhavas of growth. If in them, why I don't think 10th is concerned, I will explain. Then what happens? If benefics occupy 3, 6 and 11 from moon, then if only two, he has said, then he is Mahadhani, very wealthy. If only two places are occupied, then what happens? By benefits. Then he will be a medium, he has wealth, but not great wealth. If there is only one benefit in 3, 6 or 11, what happens? He will have very small quantity of wealth, but still he would be wealthy. This is what is being talked about. Why? Perhaps because third is the parakrama, the valor, sixth is hard work and relatives, and 11th is the labhasthana, the bhava of income, and benefits there may be increasing the good part of the those bhavas, the good indications of the bhavas, though generally it is presumed that malefics in 3, 6, 11 are good. But here the reference is from moon, not from lagna. Please remember this. Otherwise one gets confused that at one place they say that 3, 6 is 11, there should be malefics, and now they are saying there should be. No, these benefics have to be from 3, 6 and 11 houses with reference to moon, wherever moon is placed. Then the great things about which everybody is usually confused, and one of our subscribers also asked me to talk more about, which is the famous Sunapha, Anapha and Durudhara Yoga and the Kemadruma Yoga, the last but not the least, about which I will talk a bit more. Now this is Chandra Swanto Bhaya Saste Graha Surya Bina. Same thing as we have seen in Vashi Yoga. What happens if from moon in the second house or in the 12th house or in both the houses planets other than sun are placed? In Vashi Yoga, we did not want moon to be one of the planets. Here, we don't want sun to be one of the planets. Obviously, because, see, whether you put sun in the second from moon or moon in the 12th from sun, one and the same thing. So, that nullifies these yogas, the Vashi, Voshi and Ubhayachara yoga about sun, which we have seen. So, he say when it is in the second, it is called Sunapha Yoga. When it is in the 12th from moon, it is called the Anapha Yoga. When planets are placed both in the second and the 12th from moon, that is called the Durudhara Yoga. Here, instead of Ubhayachara, the nomenclature is, the only the nomenclatures are changed. The planets will be the five planets. That means excluding sun and moon, of course, because it is either with reference to moon or sun. So what happens when Sunapha Yoga happens? That is when the sun is, planet is in the second from moon, then Raja Raja Tulyova, he is equivalent to a king or almost of the same level as a king and has great intellect, money, etc., etc. And this is generally earned by his own valor. So, Bhuja Arjita, that is what is said in the shloka. I don't want to repeat all the shloka, but so Bhuja Arjita Vittascha. The wealth that he earns is on his from his own valor, based on his own valor. This is the result of the Sunafa Yoga. Sunafa Yoga Sambhava. Sambhava means one who is born in such a yoga. Bhupo Agada Shari Rascha. What happens with Anafa Yoga? When planets are in 12th from moon, what happens? He is a king. He has a healthy body. See, their intellect was great in Sunafa Yoga. Here, his body is very strong. Shilavan, he has great character. And he has great reputation. So, the effects are a bit different. And then what happens? He is also good to look at. Surupa. He says he is Surupa. Surupa means handsome. Handsome or beautiful, depending on if he is a lady, then we may call her beautiful, and if he is a male, we will call him handsome. And he is Sukhi, he is happy. So there is slight difference between the two. At one place, it is more about intellect, other place, it is about healthy body, looking handsome, and all those things. Isn't it? Then next, what happens when Durudhara Yoga happens? That is, planets other than Sun are placed in the 2nd and 12th, both 2nd and 12th, from Moon. Here, position of Moon is important. In Vaishi Vaishi Yoga, the position of Sun was important. What happens? Utpanna Supa Bhukdata Dhana Vahana Sayoga. He is happy. He is a donor, good donor. So obviously he is wealthy. That is why he says he is possessed of vehicles and wealth. Dhana Vahana Sanyuta means, dhana means wealth and vahana means vehicle. Sadbhrutyo Jayate Nunam. He also gets good employees. Who? Again, the Durdhara Bhava, one who is born in Durdhara Yoga. That means when on both the sides of moon, there are planets other than Sun. Now, there sometimes he says, if there is Sun, then these things will not happen. Kasche Syadha Vina Lagnam Chandram Lagnat. Sometimes, what happens? We have to understand. Because this is about the Kemadruma Yoga. The great yoga is now coming. Yoga Kemadruma Nama. Chandra. From the position of Chandra, if there is no planet in the second house and also on the 12th house, barring moon, sun. If sun is there, it doesn't obviously nullify the Kemadrama Yoga. Please try to understand this. And if moon is not in the Kendra from Lagna, ascendant, these two conditions have to be there. Again, as I said, in yoga, single conditions generally would not, if applied to chart, you will find that the results do not come through. Now here, Kemadrama Yoga, the yoga for penuru is being taught about. Talked about. So, what is he saying? In that case, it is called the Kemadruga Yoga. Yoga Kemadruma Nama Tatra Jata Atigarhita. Very bad yoga. When is the yoga bad? When there are no planets other than Sun, of course. On either side, on both sides, there should not be any planet. Sun can be there. And Moon should not be in square from ascendant. Both these conditions are true. In that case, a yoga called Kemadhruma Yoga, which is a very bad yoga, Garhita means not very good, worst, whatever. And what happens? Buddhi Vidya Vihinascha, he is bereft of intellect, also learning, and Daridra Apatti Sayuta. Daridra means penury, and he doesn't even have money. Now, this is one form of Kemadhruma Yoga. Generally, we talk about that. People even think that Kemadhruma Yoga means only there should not be any planets on either side of moon. No, that is wrong. If you look at charts of Lord Rama and others, you will find that they also had the so-called Kemadhruma Yoga, but they forget that moon was in Kedra from Lagna. So, anyway, it is out. But there are other acharyas who have different opinion about it. I will also talk about something about Adi Yoga after this is over, because I speak extempore and I forgot about it. Then Acharya Jeev Sharma says, no, this should also be seen in Namosha. Wherever moon is placed in Namosha, from its the second house or the 12th house should also not be occupied by any planet. Then only Kemadhruma Yoga can happen, otherwise not. Then, similarly, even there the Sanafa, Anafa and Durdhara Yoga should be seen. This is what one Acharya called Jeeva Sharma has opined. Jaimini has given a twist to this again. I would not say twist, I would rather say it is much more near what can happen. And he says, Swapitru Pada Bhagya, Roga Yoga. That means from Lagna, the Arudha Lagna, isn't it? And even the Atma Karaka or Karakamsha. If Papa Samme Kemadhruma, if there are malefic, equal number of malefics in the second and 12th bhava from the Lagna, the Pada Lagna, that is Arudha Lagna, and the Karakamsha Lagna, or even the Atma Karaka, then Kemadhruma Yoga happens. Which to my logic seems to be okay, because in the house of wealth there will be malefic, in house of legacy also there will be malefic, and they will be aspecting those houses, which means the person might not have even some good legacy, and even if it is there, it will be filtered away. So he will not be able to accumulate wealth. So this Kemadhruma Yoga with all those overriders earlier would be the one which would really give penury to a person. This is my opinion. Everybody is open to his interpretation of this. I don't think merely not having a planet in both in second and 12th from moon is going to make anybody pauper and absolutely an idiot, as it is said. He said, Buddhi Vidya Vihinascha. If he has no education, if he has no intellect, obviously, and Daridra, etc. etc. So, this is the interpretation of Kemadhruma. By the way, when we were talking about Adhi Yoga, Parashara has said there have to be benefits only, but Mantreshwara and others say that it doesn't matter. If there are malefics in 6, 7, and 8 from moon or from Lagna, of course, Lagna Adhi Yoga is also there. I have talked about it. Even then it is the Adhi Yoga, it will be called the Papa Adhi Yoga. If there are benefics and malefics both in 6, 7 and 8, then it will be called the Mishra Adhi Yoga. I think he is right in a way, because malefics in 6 itself would certainly be one of the ways, one of the yogas which do give good results, because it destroys the enemies. And so I think he is right. So that is also called Adhi Yoga. Remember that even Chandra Adhi Yoga, there can be Papa Grahas, there can be mixture of Papa and Shubha Grahas. Still it will be considered Adhi Yoga. With this, one more thing I can say is Anya Yoga Phalam Hanti Chandra Yoga Visheshataha is what is Parashara has. If Chandra Yoga is there, these yogas caused by Chandra are there in the chart, then other negative yogas of the chart will be destroyed, is what the Sesh Parashara says, Swafalam Pradadati. So he says, then Mool will give his own results, not the other's results. The good results, obviously, he means, or even the bad results, he also perhaps is implying. To me, I would not think so. Other yogas will also happen during their dashas, etc., etc., if they are good or bad, doesn't matter. And also coupled with the action taken by that person during those times when the negatives are coming, if he takes the right action, then the intensity will be much less. During good yoga, if right action is taken by the jataka, the intensity of the yogas will increase. I am already running at 25 minutes, almost 26 minutes, which is, I am overshooting my time, but Chandra yogas are interesting and I wanted to tell as much as I could about it. So, my dear friends, I'll take your leave and a very good night.